So you want to buy a Cirrus SF50 Vision Jet. It's an impressive airplane, and not just for the performance and cost, the fact that it exists at all. When a company that never built a jet before tries building a jet, it certainly doesn't mean that you're going to get a jet out the other end. Diamond tried to make a jet, the D-Jet, and Piper tried to make a jet too, the Piper Jet. Neither one of them made it to production, certainly not a result of their names being too clever. You may have already known that, but did you know Epic also tried to make a jet? Twice? And they were only planning to release these as experimental, but they didn't make it either. The summary is that making jets is tough, but Cirrus managed to pull it off, and it's going very well. There's been a waitlist to buy a Vision Jet ever since its release. When you look at the performance, it doesn't look that jetty, and it becomes apparent that the Vision Jet isn't trying to compete with jets at all. These numbers are very reminiscent of turboprop singles. It's nearly as fast as a 900 series TBM, and it's priced like a Piper M600. In case you're unfamiliar with the world of turboprop singles, TBMs are the fast ones, and Pipers are the cheap ones. Relatively speaking, of course. It's impressive that Cirrus was able to line up with these particular planes in those particular areas. Price-wise, by comparison, you could get a TBM 850 or a really early 900 series if you could find one for sale. Also, C90 GTX King Airs are about the same price, and any of the Pipers you can get for less. There's a long list of older turboprops and jets that you can get for these prices, but Cirrus Jet is really new and modern, and it's not really fair to compare it to stuff that's more than 10 years old. Jets in this price range that are less than 10 years old are pretty rare. Citation M2 is one, as well as the Mustang, although both of those jets will cost considerably more to operate. As for expenses, you don't really pay for jet maintenance in the same way that you'd pay to maintain your piston plane. What you'll do is you buy a maintenance package. It's kind of like a subscription. Cirrus calls theirs Vision Air. Everything is inspected and repaired when the times come. I tried to figure out exactly what goes into it and break it down into the nice format that I've grown to like so much, but when you work it out hourly, it looks like this. Once again, very much like a turboprop single. Sometimes people call the SF50 a crummy jet, which makes no sense to me. It's like saying the Honda Civic sucks because Lamborghinis exist. Honda knew what it was doing when it made the Civic. They didn't get all finished and then be like, geez, this isn't nearly as fast as a Lamborghini. Obviously it sucks. And Cirrus is the same. They knew they weren't building a Gulfstream. They weren't trying to build a Gulfstream. What they did do is they expanded the range in which jets exist. And they're the only company to ever certify a single engine jet. Right now there are only 4 very light jets in production, and the Cirrus is by a long shot the cheapest to buy, and by an even longer shot the cheapest to operate. If I were the market for a plane that performed to the tune of a TBM or M600, well, that'd be really nice. But wouldn't it be also nice if there was a little jet in the mix as a completely valid and possible option? I think so. All that's left to do is to get myself in the market for a TBM or an M600. That's all for this one. Thanks for watching. See you in the next.